Hi there and welcome to today's Quentin Carpenter Nature of Flowers video. Today I'm going to talk you through how to make one of these flower of life images using Photopea. I'm going to show you how to do it the mathematical way, and it's going to be really complicated, but it should take a little while. Here's one I've made earlier in Photoshop. You can see this is the pattern we're going to be ending up with, and not everyone has Photoshop at home, so we're going to do it in Photopea, and I'm going to try and talk you through it all the way from the beginning all the way to the end, hopefully without making too many mistakes. Okay, so I'm going to minimize this first of all. This is Photopea, so you go to the internet and you type in photopea.com, and it's a free website that you can then use to make images. You will need to make a new project, so we'll go File, New Project. I'm making mine 10 inches by 10 inches with 300 dots per inch and a black background. And click Create, and there's my new project. Okay, now we're going to be using the shape tool. We need to draw one shape. Once you've drawn the one shape, we're going to copy and paste that shape and do all sorts of clever things with it. So we need to find the shape tool. It will probably be set like that when you find it. So you click on it, you look for, and with Photopea, it does lag slightly sometimes, so you have to be very patient with it. So we click on ellipse. We go to the shape bit here. We don't want to fill it, so we want to make sure that we tick the box here. We want to make sure that we've got it on white, so we're doing a white picture, so we click on this one here. 10 points is the perfect size for this, but you can change the size if you want it thinner or thicker. We want it on the line, not on any other variation of that. We'll make it on a new layer, fixed size, and we're going to type in here 2800, which is going to fit perfectly within our square. Then, providing it works without any glitches today, we're going to draw our big circle. And now we're looking for a red cross. There we go. Once we've done that, we have got our circle, and it is in the right place to do all the rest of the designs from. Okay, too easy. Now, what we need to do now is go over to where it says shape one, right click on it, and duplicate that layer. So it now says shape one copy. Then we go to edit and transform, and we go to scale. Now, you see this little square box in the corner up here? We want to move the dot to the left-hand side, and then we want to come over here, tick the equal sign so that we've got equally proportioned, and type in 50%, then press enter. And you will see we now have a small circle inside a big circle. This is in exactly the right place. We don't have to move it, we don't have to make any mistakes. Okay, we press enter again. And we come over to shape one, and we do the same thing again. We duplicate the layer. It will say shape one, copy two. We then go over to edit and to transform. And this time we go to scale, and we move the little box, the little dot in the box over here onto the right hand side. And we tick in the 50%. And we've now got perfectly lined up accurate circles exactly where we want to make our first shape. Okay, that is super simple, hopefully. Next, we want to press on the top layer, press shift on the keyboard, and click on the bottom layer, so we've got all three of them selected. We then want to go to duplicate layer, and we'll now see we've got a copy of those three layers. We keep them all selected, and then we go to edit, transform, and rotate. And this time over here we type in 60 degrees. Enter. And you'll see it turns it round to make the next part of our shape. Once we do this, we press enter. And then we come over here, and we duplicate those layers, making sure we've got all three of them. So we make sure we click on all three. We go duplicate layers. We've now got nine layers. Okay, we go to a layer, edit, transform, rotate, and I always get this bit muddled up, but I'll try and remember it. We do 60 degrees again. Press enter. And now we have got virtually all of our flower of life shape. Press enter. Very laggy because of the internet. Sometimes it's worth clicking on a different tool and it will apply it. We've got one last stage to do once we have done this. We go back to the beginning, go to shape one, which is our big outside circle. We duplicate that layer. And then we go to our edit, transform, and our scale. And this time, make sure the dot's in the middle of this little square over here. And we put in 50%, and that will make the new circle of what is known as the seed of life. Okay? Too easy? Too good? Brilliant. At this point, I'd recommend saving our work. So we'll save as virtual file. And we'll call it seed of life. Okay. And you can see we've now got our seed of life that is saved. To make it into the flower of life, so if I go back to Photoshop, what we want to do here, you can see it's the same image, but it's been duplicated many times. And there's a technique to do this to get it all perfectly in proportion, which I'll show you next. So once we've got this, we take all of it bar the first circle. So we don't want that, but we click on the first bit, scroll all the way to the top, and press Shift, and highlight the whole thing, okay? Then we go to our right click. Oh, hang on, do that again. So we click on the top one, scroll all the way down to this one, and we go to duplicate a layer. And then we go to do the same process we just did all over again. So we go to transform, we go to scale, we take the thing onto the side. We come over here and make sure it's 50%. You can see we've got a little baby one inside the bigger one, okay? We will then repeat this process exactly like we did before. So we'll come over here. While they're already selected, we can duplicate them again. And then we go to edit, transform, flip horizontal. Now you see that didn't work, so that we're going to forget about. I'm going to do it the other way. I just remembered teaching you the right way, not the wrong way. So we click on the big picture here, so all the way up to there. So we've got the big ones, we duplicate when they're big. Oh, hang on, this is why it gets a bit complicated, so bear with me. We right click, duplicate those layers. Then we go to edit, transform, and we go to scale. We tick the box on the right hand side, and then we put in our 50% opacity. And there you go, that's what we wanted to see. So we've got that and that. That is perfect. So now these little chaps, we need to select all of those layers. So we've got from there all the way to there. So if we click on the top one, then we scroll down to the bottom one where it says copy 21. Copy it like that. We then go to right click, duplicate layer. And then we go to edit, transform, rotate, and we're looking for 60 degrees of rotation again. And it does that. And then we want to, well, it's all highlighted still, right click, duplicate all those layers. You see, we've got many, many layers now. And then we want to go to edit, transform, rotate, and 60 degrees again. And now we have got virtually the whole of the flower of life pattern. You will notice that the middle bit isn't quite right. So if we go back to the very, very beginning part of our piece, we select the first bit. So where are we? That one, that one all the way up to copy 9. And then we go to our edit, transform, scale, and we make sure we're in the middle, and then we tick 50%. And then we click over here. And you can see that we now have the whole pattern. What we have also got to find though, somewhere in all amongst all this, is a big version of the seed of life that we don't really necessarily need. So where is that hiding, I wonder? It's not there. I know where it'll be. What I'm looking for. Here it is. And we will make sure we get a file save as again before it crashes, because using PhotoP uses the internet, and using the internet can be a bit laggy sometimes. Now, there we go. I'll see if I can find where it is exactly. This one's here, so we lose these ones. With you, I'm a bit lost where I've gone wrong here. So what we'll do, we're just going to go edit, step backwards, 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 edit, step backwards. We're not actually doing anything by doing this. Edit, step backwards. I'm just going to pause the video a minute. Okay, so this is what it will look like. What happened there? This is what it will eventually look like when it is completed. Okay, have fun making your own versions, and hopefully using PhotoP isn't as problematic as it can be. As you can tell, doing a Photoshop, we've got a nice clean image, and I'll go back to my PhotoP one, find my file, open. I'll find one that we were doing. So it's doing that one and open it. Wait for it to load. And there you go, you see, there it is. And what we've got here is the inner circle added as well. Okay, have fun making your own, like I say, and if you have any problems, let me know in the comments below. So it's photop.com is the website to use for free. You can do it in Photoshop equally as well, probably prefer doing it in Photoshop, to be honest. And if you've enjoyed making it, pop over the channel, hit that subscribe button, and give it a thumbs up. Okay, thanks for watching, and have a lovely day. Goodbye.